Well, this is Xenoxis, and now we are recording the recruitment video. So I started it yesterday, 20th, so we need to go back to Kul Tiras. Excited, by the way, because I mean, like, some of the racials that they have is pretty good, and the thing that I'm hoping really will happen is that a lot of people are gonna stop playing humans and stuff, that you know, and that most people are just gonna be Kul Tirans instead, you know, because in my opinion it feels like Kul Tirans are pretty superior, to be honest. Alright, we're gonna go this way. Which they haven't seen a single Kul Tiran yet though, so you know. Which is a bit odd, to be honest. You know, and maybe it's just that a lot of people haven't, you know. Okay, that was a good second to build. Okay. For Kul Tiras, I can help you in your search. But what if our mysterious shipwright refuses your request?
I have prepared a letter in case some persuasion is required. I suggest you take it with you.
Aye, aye, Lord Admiral. Come, we'll start in Storm Song Valley, where we build every ship in the fleet.
What would you ask?
All right, she wants me to take the lucky. Why does this letter smell like butt? Jana likes to keep the letter in her butt. Oh, rain. That is a really cool one, it rains in Morales. Alright, it doesn't matter where it goes really, so we need to... Because I know there are some easy reps that I could use to work towards getting, you know, and stuff that. And already I want to finish the Burning Crusade chain, which I know takes about a week or whatever, do the netherwing thing. I mean, it also depends on, like, for example, if I farm Karastan every week, then the eggs, you can actually hand in the eggs and they give you quite a bit of rep as well. That's that idea also, bundle. Okay, with the eggs from other characters. And it's a bit bad also that in Old Northrend you cannot get the actual thing. Whatever you want to call it. Okay. Okay, Cyrus.
Every hand helps. We will
wouldn't brought a pike now, really, to be honest. And maybe it's the guy that gives you a quest there. Maybe. She's the one that knows it.
Times were simpler once.
Right here, are you?
Boy. The call.
Maybe it's up here. No. All right. It almost feels like they're hiding something. And the dead was.
Well met. Remain vigilant. This town's quite the rumor mill, but we've at least narrowed down our search. You're looking for a homestead somewhere in the dead wash.
They added items yet, okay, good. So what is good for plot? That one seems really good, actually. Like, first it restores health, and then it deals less damage than what you restore, but it deals it over 10 seconds, basically, so it isn't that bad, especially if you got the ones with absorb shields and stuff. Alright, I forgot about this, the effect of daily attributes and stuff that. Or even better thoughts. Ooh, I get expulsion. Ooh. Probably worth it. Or that I've been here before.
Yeah, I'm listening.
It is strange that they have. No, I want that first. So you don't get the hurricane model, of course, obviously. Wait. What did I want me to? Okay. But get in the cart. What did I say? Get in the cart? There's no cart here. Now of course some of the things are better than others, of course, when it comes to, you know, things. What the quest here I missed. Huh? That seems weird. That I would have missed quests here. This actually count, which is actually very, very good that they do. I will replace this one. Or maybe it would be worth otherwise if I were to save up cash. How much is it for the Lightforge Warframe, by the way? I forgot how much it is for it. I think it's over 200,000 extra for Lightforge Warframe. I think. Distance with this, and I'm gonna step back. I wonder how long this question is. I mean, sometimes it's good if there's a really long quest line, but sometimes it's also boring. Sometimes it depends on how much makes sense, you know, that you do and stuff that, because I mean, the I think, you know, the Dark Island Dwarf made a lot of sense. You know, the Dark Island Dwarf was really cool, the fact that you had to go into Firelands. I was... It's a little version of Firelands that you went into, you know, and stuff that was pretty cool. You know, and, you know, like, yeah. Pole arm, which is just, you know, two-handed. Ugh. Okay, so let's go over here now. Alright, this is this. Okay, heavy number. Hey, you know, I know all about lumber, you know. From doing the animal stuff. Yeah, you move slower, obviously. But she has shaman spells. Alright, because they can be shamans. Damn, do you even lift, bro? If you know how much actual wood actually is, depending on how solid it is, of course, you know, like there are also. Snap. Yeah, I'm in the lead in the race. Super and not super. Slow your cart. First, to do the lumber thing, and then we'll fly to the other place, the place that's over here, to Colleen after that. And I mean, they're called Thorn Speakers, but obviously what they show there, at least though, like the when you do the onion that we did, the or I mean, yeah, because men are with the whole Gorgthul thing, that Gorgthul is like his, like a druid as well. It looks like they used the model for the Geist thing, but also that they used that for the Pale Orc, sort of. Okay. Alright, the invasion has probably ended. Yeah, it has. That's a bit sad. Alright, don't go near that. Killing and that stuff. Oh, that was also 5, I think, but it looked like it was more than it was. Because I slept very, very little last time I slept, and then I also, you know.
Keep your distance.
No, I don't think it's really far, okay. If they are based on Scandinavian style roots or like Norse mythology style roots, there are certain similarities to Norse mythology actually with the Drost actually. Keep trying to convince all for the goat form would be amazing. It I've been here before, you know, and stuff that because you've been here, you know, because otherwise you wouldn't be able to be at this point, you know, so yeah. Yeah, so he's talking about death and stuff like that. Him before Ulfar is the big evil. Okay. I've been sad about this whistle. We own some more hematites. Okay. And then we fly to Osman's Rise. Right family. Oh well. Ikke er you. Pussy. Några ska vi. Oh, my keys. Who is he? Oh, look, it's in the side of the house, huh? Oh, it's haha. Come here, you. So the wicked beast, they become wicked when they die. So this is literally a dog that became undead. So he was just trying to play. Princess. I could make such a long tweet all of a sudden. It is that because I'm worried if I don't Twitter then? Maybe it is, maybe I finally got to worry if I don't Twitter. Wait. Because I'm walking the dog. Alright, so we need to find its possessions. So maybe we can restore the dog? I hope I get this as a pet. Okay. Yeah, princess. I already figured out that it was called princess. Spoilers. Inside a house. So I'm guessing the family lived here, but then the family got killed. Most likely. Ugh. A fishing family from the looks of it. A bit. But probably like a mining family also. That I can't decide actually what I'm gonna play as. It's the Kul Tirans and stuff though, so let me heal up. That clock looks really nice though. I don't like the physics of the thing, you know. Huh? Did you dig something up? I would almost want this wiki piece stacks instead. He's my friend now. Ah, it followed you and she's afraid. Okay, and now we need to go to... Where do we need to? Alright. Right. Can you teleport me there? Oh, of course not. Nice. This is actually a fun little scene, to be honest, you know. It's actually not bad at all, you know. I wonder if the war campaign is like we'll put a war effort here. No. Yeah, when you complete both of them, you receive a mount for both factions, basically, which is quite cool. One of them, of course, is a Frostwolf thing, and the other thing, I believe, is an actual... what do you call it? An actual Elec? Well, like one of the Draenorysk Elecs, I think. To be honest, Blitzet doesn't look that bad, to be honest. Because, you know, like, actual bones have been used as actual armor, you know, way back in the day. Because, I mean, why wouldn't it, you know, because bones can be pretty, pretty strong, actually, you know, if it's layered correctly, you know, stuff like that, so, yeah. The elemental recipe is part that we figure out now inside its standard. The elemental EX depends into your face. That's what happened when you use air elemental. Oh man. This is funny because it's my... That's the thing, like, you have to think about, you know, like, the fact that maybe it's just that Kul Tirans aren't that used to be, you know. Boop-a-da-boo. purple I like best. Vad är det här nästa? Elementals.
She's just a tad shy. Play her no mind. Or would you like some warm milk while you wait?
Yes. Thank you.
Okay. Oh, recruit a crew. Can I decide a crew? Is this gonna be the player housing? Wait, where do I? Okay, do that. This is actually good to teleport back here, because then it's like, you know, I think that this is probably one of the best hotstone locations, the one in Mage Court, because that just gives you access to the teleport room. And the places that you cannot reach via this teleport room, you can just go to the other place in Stormwind here. I thought you could only get that because I'm in combat because of those things. I am out of range. I need to get closer. I am out of range. I need to fart in your butt. I mean, yes, there's a bunch of mounts you could get and stuff that as well, so yeah. Because I want to make sure also I get the fight paths as well, so yeah. Ugh. Let's just manually ride here. Look, instead of flying, you know, sort of manually ride. That is something that I thought about, like, what if they got inspired by something like Red Dead Redemption, so that you could have quests that would be like how the whole thing is with Sylvanas in, like, Silpine Forest, how you're all together with her, and that there would be like a way to, like, for example, if you're having a long travel thing, then you would travel together with an NPC, and then you'd have like a conversation, and then there would be like a cinematic camera that would play it out like a cutscene, you know, and stuff that that would be pretty cool if that could be the case. Yeah. Right, you learn about Nomragun that way. And any pets? That's where you get this, by the way, and that as well. How many do I have, by the way? Did I put them in a... Okay, so I have 34. You can upgrade, of course, the rare with that. So yeah. I was spending a long time in here at one point trying to like pet everything and stuff like that. Rough waters, that makes so much sense. But yeah. My mom was seeing all of these things and being like, oh man, imagine if you could buy all of these things and stuff like that. Like I've thought about how I think that they're gonna make the thing happen. I wonder if they have new recipes here now. I know that I can actually make the blood sausages thing. Then what do you call it? Blood sausages, yeah. Ugh. Can I wanna go door this way? So we can go up here. Keep in mind that boar chests are not the same as the other things and stuff like that. Ugh.
I will honor my father's legacy. May the seas guide you.
Aye, I was just thinking on her request. I've a few in mind, but some of them might take more convincing than others. Brother Pike is currently here in Barats. He's my first choice for Pike's sake. No ship sails without one. For my master gunner, I'll have none other than Lieutenant Tiran. He should still be stationed at the vigil. Meet me at Outrigger Post, where we can find the rest of our crew.
Okay. Damn, I wish I had a goblin glider. At this point, right. I could just go back this way as well. And this mini display map is pretty good. The worst thing though is that you need to to change the size of the interface or to make things like the map bigger, then you actually need to go in and change like the thing, the thing, the UI scale. It's a bit bad. I kind of wish that you could like just go in and change the map a little bit, just to make it slightly more wide or something like that, just And I can also know the way I want my character to look though. Can I see? See, another one was at Vigil Hill, they said. Okay, so Brother Pack, I'm guessing, is just down below here somewhere. What it is.
The storm awakens in us. It has been too long since I have seen the bones. The legacy of the time surges has been attended. But perhaps I can help. Besides, how could I refuse the Lord Admiral's brother?
Okay. Next up is the video health thing. Wait. Right. Excellent. Exactly what I want to wait. Can I? Yeah, I can. Wait. Haha. We'll go over there. of course to the outriggers then after that. Yeah. And it might be actually faster to fly there, depending on the route it takes, because that's the thing that you should always look for. The route it takes when you do something. Oh my. The best fish in the market, not trout. So I get a bit more tired, so I have an easy time sleeping later. Okay. Good. Well, that does a lot. Also, I was able to hit the Windows button there without it crashing. That's interesting. Okay, and outriggers. Right.
Child, I'm sure. Best of luck.
Okay, so it's gonna go boom over into the last war. Hit up Hangman's Point, Barbiton Ridge, and then it will go to the place. It would have been cool if you would have decided the crew on the ship though. But I guess it makes sense. But I think that's weird that this takes place before the battle. For that's all a lore it must do. Because you use the tide sage on to your advantage basically during the siege and stuff that, like in order to camouflage the ships and stuff that. Then it seems weird because, yeah, it's just... Okay, we're almost at the maximum now. Okay. Meet at what did he? Four? Tied? Nani? Ah! Boatswain. Alright. We see this boss moon. And then we have to find Shack Tool power to it. Okay, so yeah, that doesn't look too bad. Yeah. So that's the daily quest progress, that's the world quest progress. Now it is a bit sad that 3,000 is the maximum amount for quests used, and then like these go up to 5,000 and stuff like that, and it's just weird, like, why couldn't they just have made like more requesting? I wonder how many quests I've done on this character, because I mean, like, completing daily quests and completing world quests counts towards the quest total, right? Yeah, 8,957 on this specific character. Okay, daily quest done on this character, okay. What? Really, I mean, that's not strange, really, to be honest. Considering if you change your character's skin color, then that is a lot. That's pretty interesting that you can see that stuff that, like, yeah. I mean, like, I always love statistics and stuff that, and that's something that I...
Name a better bosun and I'll take it instead. You wanted the best. You are the best.
Come on, out with it.
Taste. Wait. Alright, it's done already, it's the ship over there.
I will do what I can.
Choose the name. Tiffin brain, basically.
The choice is yours, champion.
Do I talk to you?
We cannot let the world fall
to Lion Heart, of course. Obviously.
Well chosen.
Limit break. Or special, or whatever desperation attack they call it in 8.
I see this coming.
look the horses in. Is it gonna be super loud?
Storm above and tides below, hear us now. Breathe strength into our
sails. I wonder if he would say the name that you've chosen.
Let this vessel be one with a vast ocean and us with her. Sea to sea.
Okay, that explains why the ships are so good. I wonder if you want to see the people that have chosen lying out on the boat then. Kul Tiran charge! Look at my horse is amazing. Give it a lick, it tastes just like pussy with that stock of its mane. Oh wow, we're gonna drive this to Stormwind. Yeah, we are. Please tell me we... Oh yeah, we are gonna drive it to Storm. Boy. Alright, this was... Oh, it's really, really big. Compared to City Tiny Alliance ships. Oh. Pretty interesting. Wow, this interior is really cool actually. I mean, there are other ships that has this interior as well, but it's still really, really cool.
When you asked to meet me at the harbor, I had no idea what you had in mind. This is incredible.
Kul Tiras and the Alliance once shared a bond of friendship. Now both of our peoples will see that bond.
And prisons here. Or, you know, sex dungeon giggity. If they're taking some kind of secret vote that they would decide on what's gonna happen in the story depending on, you know, what people choose. Or imagine if this makes the path different in the story for you depending on what you have chosen and stuff like that. Cool. Nice. I mean, this is cool too, but you know, pretty big ship.
The true battle lies ahead.
A king is old, you ask of Herr Krause.
Speak your terms.
But wait, but how did Tandor get captured? It's interesting. I really think there's nothing else here then. No. Huh? Why can't I? Alright, I'm too fat when I had that. This looks very, very high res, to be honest. This one. I wonder if I should go with maxing and matching transmog for it. I think I can, actually. Oh, it's really, really, really impressive, the bot. And of course, that's the thing, that their ships are magical, you know, and stuff that, that makes a lot of sense, you know. This one darker. It is, but it still doesn't match the thing. Maybe there is a better chest piece somewhere. Hang on, let me just hide this first so I can see her a bit better. I think it is this one you get, since this one has to do with aswell, but that is the set that is meant to go with the... Sea Raider. If this was the one that matched the most, though. Because otherwise, for example, you would have to go with... all the pieces of that set, of the Waycrest set. Which might be more fitting actually. First one on each one, I think that that's maybe because the first one is, yeah, oh, it's shoulder breach. Wrong then. Short breach, which is also known as thread corsair. So there is in the middle. That's a bit odd that they've done that that way, like it's always the one to the right normally. Thread corsair, thread corsair, thread corsair. But then it's not the most, that is a bit odd. Should actually just take a green one, you know, and have that match that way instead, you know, that that could definitely be the case, maybe. Supposed to fit with this the most. this, and now I want to go to the place. Fly there, actually. Is the who's what is here? If there is any kind of follow up to it, because yeah. So yeah, and then I'm just gonna record a short video. Just we're gonna test out the Kul Tirans a bit. Of course, obviously. I'm gonna obviously just, you know, check Elam prices first and stuff that, and decide like how many we get, you know, and not just, you know, like do what I normally do. So haymaker, smash opponents, stunning and knocking them back. All taste gets increased, swim faster and breath longer underwater. Resistance to frost and nature damage, increased versatility. So that, like, the versatility thing seems really good. Could I see the classes that could be? No. Nice and here. And most likely with Megatork being damaged, then most likely they're probably saving him via the thing. They're probably saving him via making him a Mechanome. So yeah. The thing is, of course, obviously if we're gonna level up a lot of plate users, for example, then it would make sense to go for some of the playthings. But then the question is, do I like focus around on the one set? Or like, what do I focus on? Of course, obviously I focus on these two cloaks here, because these two cloaks are really, really good, because obviously they have other stats on them and stuff that, because, you know, like, they do have verse on those cloaks, because yeah, that one is crit and burst, but yeah, also it's very, very similar to that one, or this one is very, very similar to that one. But it's haste first instead of crit and versus, yeah. It makes it pretty, pretty unique, you know. So now we'll go to Ironforge, so we need to go here. So Ironforge, Pardon, Village, Shatra, Exodar, Dalaran, Pardon. So wait, there is now portal to Stormshield. I'm curious, do Stormshield even have teleports? Because if Stormshield still has teleports, then that could maybe... I mean, Stormshield must make sense if it has teleports, right? Because how otherwise would you leave? So Stormshield, do they at least have teleports here? Do they have... No Ironforge portal. No... The Nurse's portal. It is the only portal here gonna be Stormwind. You do have the Lancewatch portal still, that makes sense, you know, obviously. But do you have... Yeah, okay. So, do I have to always add the Deep Run Tram then to go to Ironforge? No, I don't. We'll go to Boralus. Boralus. Paralys? No. No way. No, this place is kind of interesting though. Huh? What was that, me walking? Yeah, that's huh. So, the thing with Paralys, of course they can obviously just expand here later on and stuff that. You know, and those reminded me specifically of that thing, but yeah. So now we go here. We go to Ironforge. Then I'm gonna take a piss. And then I'm gonna take a piss, and then we're gonna just do a little bit to record more. Yeah, hopefully I don't have to eat again before I go to bed though. Stop that. Oh, I'm so close to pissing myself. So, damn it. No. Phew, that was close. I thought, because I know that they're most expensive now, like they have price reduced them a lot, so they're not really that expensive. Like usually the most expensive things are the weapons. But the question is, do you really need alien weapons, and how well do they scale, you know? Obviously nothing is going to beat the health scheme decapitator, but you cannot use that from lower level enough. I wish there would be a way to activate that, to use that earlier and stuff that, so you know, like for the people that have earned the health scheme decapitator, you know, to make it, you know, really good. So that is still that, okay. So yeah, I wanna get first this here, surviving Kalimdor, because this gives you surviving Kalimdor for Alliance, but it also gives you walking Kalimdor with the Earth Mother, so it gives you both of those, and I believe they will be at so toy surviving Kalimdor and walking with the Earth Mother. So these basically earn you a bunch of different flight points, of course, obviously, which makes them really, really useful. So we want to get... wait, is it up to 1 or 10 on the axe? Yes, it is. So I want it up to 120 now. Okay. Okay, let's see how strong it gets. 287. 287 is not too shabby, actually. Make it work up until, especially since you can put two XP things on it as well. It's pretty good. Next up, we want to probably get... Do I want the crit or do I want the haste? That's the thing, like, do you want the crit or the haste? Like usually I would go with the haste always, you know, and stuff that seems, because it's already 1 of 10, so then I need to waste less. So you can see that's 5,000, okay. So then we'll take this haste one. Boom. I have the crit one there, but I'm gonna go for the haste one here, so I need this and this. And put this on here, and then put this one on here. Okay, and then we're in for the cloak. And make the cloak 1 of 10, and then make it 1 of 20. Get another one.
Watch your back.
And we go for 120 on the chest piece.
How are ya?
And then 120 on leggings. Boom. And we need this. And we need this. I'm gonna put that on the ring. Put that on the ring, boom. And put that on the ring. I also probably need a shield to upgrade in case we want to be tanking. So boom that. Put this on the shield. So then we also need to put on some on the one-hander. I forgot if it was 1 of 10 or not. The one-hander. So Spirit of Retu. So I need to put that on the Bloodforge thing. So I need the one-hander thing as well. Which is this one. So first this one here. On the one-hander sword. Boom. Boom. And then bring this up to 1 of 10. And then get to the 121. So see, you're going through the cache really, really quickly, you know. Which is why it's good just to focus around one thing at a time, basically. You know, so then we have a good two-hander and we have, we'll have a good... weapon along it too.
I cannot use that. What can I do for you?
Okay, sell this back. That was weird. I have no idea why that doesn't wanna get up to 110 though. That's weird. That's really odd. Right, let's go in on all specializations here, so... Alright, trinkets also, and stuff, so... To 110, we need to... No, not that. We need to, once, let's go up to 110. Okay, so I would like to take it on the amulet, but it's probably better to take on, you know, something that gives versatility though. Just because, you know, yeah. No, let's just take it on this then, boom. Take that to 1 of 10. Take the haste one to 1 of 10. Boom. And then get to 5,000 ones. Make this one 120. Make this one 120. Or offhand. So maybe this counts as... Maybe this is for one-handed weapons. Maybe, I don't know. Okay, so... Yeah, see. That's weird. That's weird that that would be, that that would work that way, because I did use this to upgrade it, so I don't know why they have made it that way. That seems weird, but anyway, so I think that's gonna do it actually. I think those are the ones that I want to have, so far at least, upgraded. I want to upgrade a horde cloak also, just so. So upgrade to 1 of 10. No, not this one. That's a weapon one. To 1 of 10. Right, because it's up to... What is it up to? The old one. Okay, so this is 1 of 10. Make it up to 100. Right. So, use this one first on the old cloak. Use this one on the old cloak, and then you use the 120 on the old cloak. Right. There we go. Now we have some pretty decent. Now we have 120s on each of the slots, basically now. So yeah, we're gonna look out, and we can finally create our Kul Tiran new. We can create our Kul Tirans, and we can choose between warrior, hunter, rogue, priest, shaman, this is pretty cool actually, mage, monk, and druid. And druid is of course really really cool with them as well, but yeah, shamans look pretty dope though, not gonna lie how dope the shamans look. I mean, certain classes I think will be really really good with this, you know, so yeah, I'm gonna just go and piss and I'll be right back, and we're gonna do a short call.